Burası geldi.
Можно?
Good.
Hostel, one this hostel instead of hotel.
Wanji?
Wanji? Kan, tak pernah juga.
Oh, itu sebuah, itu sebuah.
Him, you know, the kingdom, the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
Mifule.
Christ have mercy.
Oh, my shepherd, my God. The second reading. Second Timothy, chapter 4, verse 7 to 9. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day. And not to me only, but also to all those who have loved his appearing. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord. Let's please raise your hands for
welcome you as we come to celebrate the life of our God, the life of our friends, the life of our colleagues, the life of our grandfather. Today, Chandia, George Mickey, whom God has called himself. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome the honorable members of parliament who are here. We have our friends, Honorable Chakwanyi Robert, popularly known as Bob One.
Touched the lives of many people, but above all,
serve for ourselves, where is my influence? When we make a resolution to serve God, God for sure, as you have said in the gospel, He will give us the rooms, for there are many rooms in His Father's house, Jesus says. There are many people sometimes when God has blessed us with resources, we may not look back to thank God. But this has not been the case with the same God. Has been always there, as have been informed, has been very instrumental in the Diocese of Arua, supporting our local church. Supporting our local church. I'm also told he has been a mobilizer, a great mobilizer. Whenever there is a function attending to the church, he has been always taking the lead. Something which may be rare to some people. So we thank him for that generosity and also participating in building the kingdom of God here on earth. And therefore, we pray that may his soul be among of those of the righteous, to be in the hands of God, that he may not suffer torment, that God may be merciful enough and forgive him all that he might have done while he lived. Jesus today, as we have heard in the gospel reading, is giving us a pledge for those who believe in him. In my Father's house are many rooms. But maybe you can ask ourselves, who are the owners of these rooms? These rooms, they are supposed to be for all of us. However, we need to work for them. Amen. We need to work. Because God is not going to impose himself to us. God has created us. He has given us knowledge and wisdom and the will. And he respects our will. So when we make fundamental option to choose God, we choose life. But should we alienate ourselves from God, we choose death. And death is unknown. How do we know that one has made a resolution to choose God? By the way we conduct ourselves. Today we live in a society where there's a lot of brutality. People are murdering others, just as yesterday we buried the superior general of Anakawa's brothers, Brother Emmanuel Nombard Mugarula. You find such people who perpetrate those kind of acts. They have alienated themselves from God. Their conscience no longer functions. Because you can imagine that kind of brutality. Someone choosing to pay evil for good. But when we choose God, definitely there will be indicators. We shall be peacemakers. We shall be people who promote justice. We shall be people who promote God's activities. And of course, Jesus invites us to be sacramental people. For the sacraments, they are very essential in our lives. Jesus is aware that here on earth, we have so many things which do trouble us. Night and day, we labor so much. That when it comes to the end of every month, the tenants are always worried because they have to pay. But Jesus, the good news, has paid for us, amen. Jesus has paid for us, those who are righteous, those who do his will. It's only that moment that Jesus is going to give each one of us the key to our own rooms. Because we are paid by pouring out his precious blood for my sake and for your sake. And Jesus, when he said that you know where I'm going, Thomas, on our behalf, he said, Lord, we do not know where we are going. How can we know the way? And Jesus, he asserts that I'm the way, I'm the truth, and I'm the life. And no one comes to the Father but by me. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the resurrection. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the life. Sometimes we may put all of our trust in worldly things, in human beings, and all that doesn't count. We need to put our full trust and totally surrender ourselves to the Lord Himself, who is the way, the truth, the resurrection, and the life. St. Paul, when he's reflecting upon his own life, he glorifies himself in the cross. Said, I fought a good fight, and what awaits me is the crown. The crown. Sometimes our friends, they have that slogan, the crown. But this fraud which we are talking about, it is unquenchable. The glorified throne which Jesus is going to confer on those who have been faithful to their calling. Jesus, who has called us, he has a purpose for each one of us. And his purpose is that none of us should get lost, but rather should have eternal life. But all this will be possible if we choose God. If we choose God. Somebody put a book somewhere. I said, God is not great. If God is not great, who is great? Is it the author of that book is great? No. That book is wrong. Nobody can equate himself to God. Because God, to just out of his mercy, is love that we do exist. God is so merciful. He's so merciful that he had to send his only Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. He gave us the best of the best. That is none other than his only Son, who came. And like the Father, he has also given us the best of the best of himself, allow himself to die. Well, death on the cross, so that through his death may be able to win many to himself. We live in a society where people they call themselves very busy, very busy. One may not have time to go to church, but of course the mosque, I'm very busy. Can you imagine that if you are very busy for God? What hope do you have? When we choose God, we choose life. When we choose God, we choose true and everlasting happiness. But when we alienate ourselves from God, consequently, we choose death. That eternal suffering torment. Just imagine, we know very well, if one by mistake you touch fire like this, the scientists will tell us that impulses will send the message very fast, to the brain, they say there is danger. Remove your finger and you will reach immediately. What about now, where you are committed forever? Imagine the kind of suffering. Of course, God does not choose what judge anybody. We choose to be to judge ourselves, depending on the way we conduct ourselves. Each one of us is supposed to be a custodian. sister. Is that the case? A steward. Are we stewards to our brothers and sisters? How do we handle one another? Do we handle them according to the law of God? Love one another as we love ourselves. Zechariah knew that his redeemer lives, and that's why he was doing his best. Support God is program. Live in harmony with others. To share whatever he had with the rest. To promote the common good. What is my attitude towards others? Am I a representative of Christ? For St. Paul says we are ambassadors of Christ. If you are an ambassador, you must represent your country back home. And our country back home in the real sense, it is in heaven. Amen. Because we are going to our homeland. And therefore we have the duty to represent God Himself, who has created us in His own image and likeness. During this Eucharist, let us pray to God, who is full of mercy and compassion, that we may have mercy upon our dad who is lying here. That we may forgive him all that he might have done while he lives. That he may find in him justice. And also we pray for the family. God console them during this moment of grief. That God may send them the gift of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit who consoled Mother Mary. Mother Mary, whilst was there standing at the foot of the cross, seeing her only son, that great agony. Yet, with the faith, she has continued to bear. And the same God filled her with glorious glory at the resurrection of this time. Let us have faith in the risen Lord. Christ, who is the truth, the way, the resurrection, so that we too, at one day, may be able to be with him. stand up so far our prayers to God. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we thank you, we glorify you, we thank you for the gift of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the author of our lives, the truth, the resurrection, and the way. Like to pray for the Mother Church, the Holy Father, the bishops, priests, people, religious men and women, and the entire flock, that we may continue to increase in ours, in our hearts, the hope of the resurrection, and also we may be able to shepherd your flock and lead them back home to you. Lord, hear us.
Lord, listen to us.
Lord Jesus Christ, as the author of the resurrection, you have said there are many rooms in your Father's home. We pray that our Zay and George Miggy may also be one of the beneficiaries of the rooms you have prepared for us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
We pray for the family that we may continue to console them during this moment of grief. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
We pray for Johnny Masses that from here as they will be taking him back home. God may grant them their masses, cover them with his precious blood, and take them safely to our Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
In silence, let us so far our prayers and petitions to God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Together with Mother Mary, let us ask her to continue to present our prayers and petitions to God as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. We ask for the true Christ of our Lord. Amen. brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to the Lord of our God. As we humbly present you this sacrificial offering, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Chandia George Gwinki, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge. Who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Adding on the
eating well, eh?
Our gun is paying.
Banna musoka muleka tulele fena lumu akole mulundi gumu linda okatu bona basoke baje lumu akole mulundi gumu. Bane, tu sembele ke mabega, eh? Tu sembele ke mabega. Au. Ya.
By election, and up to now, there's been no conversation. What are you doing? What do you intend to do to help?
First of all, it is sad. It is sad that we lost yet another noble Ugandan. It is sad that we lose only the good people. But you know, those are the ways of God. We have nothing to do about it. We all know that Jose Chandia's hotel was raided, vandalized, and he has never been compensated. But that is not a surprise to us, because we know even 34 years later, even those that lost their things in the Welo have not been compensated. We're only sad that we're losing an honest man, a person that refused to be compromised, the person that refused to sit on the values that they represent. We lost a noble Ugandan. Personally, I lost a person that saved my life, a person that refused to sell me out even when he did know him. And we pray that God strengthens his family and continues to rest him in eternal peace. This gentleman is the owner of Pacific Hotel, where I was arrested from, where guns were planted, and we know that the regime offered lots of money for him to lie that indeed the guns were found in my room, but he refused. So those are the people that we need to build in New Uganda. Unfortunately, they're the people we are losing now.
So you mean you had been told to say he had put guns?
Yes, we know that he was pressured to say that guns were found in my room, but he refused.
And when he refused, what was the consequence of his refusing?
Well, we know that he went through so much intimidation and pressure, but he stood his ground. And that's one of the reasons why we continue to celebrate him now. Muruganda. Kyanaku nnyo nti tufuiridwa omuntu omwesimbu. Kinajukirwa nti omwami ono woteri ye yalumbibwa gye bamukwatira mu Arua, gye batulugunyiza onalibwe zaake, gye batira ne muganda wafe Yasin Kawuma. Omwami ono bagezaako mutiisatiisa n'okugezaako mugulirira asobole okulimbira wamu ne gavumenti nti ddala kyali kituufu batukwatira emundu mu woteri yaffe naye yagaana okulimba. Nebagezaako mutiisatiisa n'agaana n'ayimirira ku mazima. So kibi nnyo nti tufiirwa abantu ab'amazima era olw'ensonga eyo twongera okusaba Katonda agumye famire ye naye amuwumuze emirembe. Ya twategezebwa nti atuuse kufa nga tebanamuliyirira bintu bye byayonoonebwa. Naye tekitwewunyisa kuba tumanyi tulina oluvannyuma lw'emyaka 34 n'abaafiirwa ebintu byabwe e Luweero tebanabakuliyirirwa.
Thank you.
Thank you.